command of these, I'm the EOC commanding Southern Area Relief Force, with special responsibility for any rescue to the mechanical production of any kind. Don't think I'm joking. Now, as this is a stereophonic report, I have to go through the routine test details. So I'm going to walk from this speaker here to that speaker over there. Are you ready? Right. Here we go. Left.
Last week, the Royal Fisherman's Club was abusively by one of the world's Arthur Toolshed Jackson. Mr. Jackson, I'm just sidetracked. What shall I call your nickname? Toolshed. How did you come by it?
I don't use it myself, but some of my friends. I've only got one, and had one for some time.
In spite of the fact that you have only one, and are you still intending to purchase the second share?
No.
To bring you in line with your epithet?
No.
I see. To return to your symphony, did you write this symphony in the shed?
No.
Have you written any of your recent works in this shed of yours?
No, not at all. It's just an ordinary garden shed.
I see. And you're thinking of buying this second shed to write in.
No. Look, this shed business, it doesn't really matter. The sheds aren't important. You friends call me two sheds, and that's all there is to it. I wish you'd ask me about the music. Everybody talks about the sheds. They've got it out of proportion. I'm a composer. I'm going to get rid of the shed. I'm fed up with it.
Then you'll be after no sheds, Jackson, eh?
No, forget about the sheds. They don't matter.
Mr. Jackson, I think with respect, we ought to return to the subject of your symphony. I understand that you used to be interested in train spotting. I understand that about 30 years ago you were interested in train spotting.
What was I going to do with my bloody music?
Like what? Well, for a start, he wants to go next Poland. North Minded Conservative, isn't it?
Edward Ross on the other side.
Exactly. Well, we interviewers are more than a match for the likes of you, Toolshed.
Yes, make yourself scarce, Toolshed. This studio isn't big enough for the three of us.
What do you do? Stop it!
It's your own art program, Mr. Perry.
Arthur Toolshed. One day, Vicky the Magic Taxi went to visit Daisy Bumble in her tumble-down cottage. He found her in the bedroom. Roughly, he grabbed her heaving shoulders, pulling her down onto the bed hurriedly and ripping off her thin... Old Nick, the sea captain, was a rough, tough, jolly sort of fellow. He loved the life of the sea, and he loved to hang out down by the pier where the men dressed as ladies. Rumpel Tweezer ran the Dinky Tinky Shop in the foot of the magic oak tree by the wobbly dum-dum tree in the shade of the magic glade down in Dingley Dell. Here he sold contraceptives and bread. Harry Stokes was... with a melon? That's all for today, children.
Stop messing about with the speeds.
No, not at all.
I miss you so very much.
Oh, thank you really mean.
What do I do? I'm falling in love with you.
Oh, Victor.
It's silly, isn't it?
No, not at all, dear sweet Victor.
No, not that. I meant us being so... being so close to him in the soft clay department all those months and never dare.
Oh, Victor.
Oh. Can that be?
Try to get rid of them.
I'll get them.
Hello. Remember me?
No, I'm not.
In the pub. at all seen one with a moustache about 3 years ago.
Oh.
Only you said we must have a drink together sometime, so I thought I'd take you up on it as the Film Society meeting was cancelled this evening.
Well, it is a little bit awkward.
Hello,
tonight,
I'm Arthur.
Oh, hello.
Arthur name by name but not by nature. I always say that, don't I, Vic?
Yes, well, look.
Is this your wife?
No.
Oh, but... I get the picture. Well, don't mind me, Vicky boy. I know all about one-night stands.
I beg your pardon?
Do you mind if I take that record off?
We put that one on.
Here's a good one. What's brown and sounds like a bell?
I beg your pardon?
What's brown and sounds like a bell? Dung. That's a good one, eh? Look, I'll wait here till you finish. Don't mind me.
Who the...
I'll get it. It'll be my friends. I took the liberty of inviting them along.
Look, we were trying to have an evening on our own.
Oh, they won't mind. They're very broad-minded.
Good evening. My name is Equator. Brian Equator, light round the middle of the earth, only with an L. This is my wife, Audrey. She smells a bit, but she has a heart of gold.
Look, there's been a misunderstanding, I'm afraid.
Who's that then?
What?
Who's the bird?
I'm very sorry.
You've got a nice pair there, love. Shut up, you bitch. It's only a bit of fun.
Now, excuse me.
Big gin, please.
I'll get it.
Look, don't touch those drinks.
I'm going to have 3 tins of beans, please.
I told you to lay off the beans, you all.
I'll only 3 tins.
Button your lip, you ratbag. It was rather witty, wasn't it? Where's my gin?
Who the hell's that?
Oh, I took the liberty of asking along an old friend, as his wife has just passed away, and he's somewhat distraught, poor chap.
Come on in, Mr. Freight.
Oh, hello, Tigers. What a simply ghastly place.
Yes, it's not too good, is it? A pint of creme de menthe for my poofy friend. I'll sit here. Bit lumpy. Oh, no wonder I was sitting on the cat.
I've asked along a simply gorgeous little man I picked up outside the Odeon.
Is he sexy?
Oh, I'm sorry I had to bring the goat, only he's not at all well. I only hope he don't go on a carpet.
Come on, love, drop him. Blimey, she don't go much, does she?
Oh, wet him.
Oh, the goat's gone poos.
Look, what the hell do you think you're doing? Get out of here, all of you, get out!
I beg your pardon.
I'm turning you all out. Get out. I'm not having a crowd of filthy perverts in my flat. I'm giving you half a minute and then I'm going to call the police.
I don't like the tone of your voice. Right, lads, let's have Jerusalem.
And in those feet in ancient time, walk upon England's mountains green.
There will now be a short intermission. Our sales staff will visit all parts of the cinema.
Albatross! Albatross!
2 chalk ices, please.
I haven't got any chalk ices. I just got this albatross.
What flavour is it?
Well, it's a bird, mate. It's a bird. It's not any bloody flavour.
It's got to have a flavour. Everything's got a flavour.
Well, it's a bleeding albatross, isn't it? It's bleeding seabird flavour.
Do you get wafers with it?
Of course you don't get bloody wafers.
How much is it?
9 pence.
Well, I'll have 2, please.
Are you? Store me petrol on a stick. Damn it, Ripple.
Hello, Mr. and Mrs. Johnson.
That's right, yes.
Oh, come on in. Excuse me not shaking hands. I've just been putting a bit of lard on the cat's boil.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, you must be tired. It's a long drive from Coventry, isn't it?
Well, we usually reckon on 5.5 hours, and it took us 6 hours and 53 minutes with a 25-minute stop at Frampton Cottrell to stretch our legs, so we had to wait half an hour to get onto the M5 at Droitwich.
Really?
Then there was a 3-mile queue just before Bridgewater on the A38. We usually come round on the B3339, you see, just before Bridgewater.
Yeah, really?
But we tried to risk it, because they're always saying they're going to widen it there.
Oh,
yes, well, just the intersection there where the A372 joins up. There's plenty of room to widen it there. There's only grass verges. They can get another 6 feet, knock down that hospital. Then we took the coast road through Willington and we got all the Taunton traffic on the A358 from Crowcombe and Stockenburg.
Well, you must be dying for a cup of tea.
Well, wouldn't say no, not if it's warm and wet.
Well, come on in the lounge. I'm just going to serve afternoon tea.
Very nice.
Come on in, Mr. and Mrs. Johnson, and meet Mr. and Mrs. Phillips.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
It's their third time here. We can't keep you away, can we? And over there is Mr. Hilter.
Good time. Good afternoon.
Oh, planning a little excursion, eh, Mr. Hilter?
Yeah. We have a little, what's this, what's the name?
Hiking.
Oh, yes, we make a little hike from Biddeford.
Oh, yes, well, you'll want the A39. Oh, no, you've got the wrong map there. This is Stalingrad.
Oh.
You want the Ofricum and Barnstable section.
Oh, Stalingrad. Reginald, you have the wrong map here, you silly old leg before wicked English person.
I'm sorry, my dicky old chum.
Oh, lucky Mr. Johnson pointed that out. You wouldn't have had much fun in Stalingrad, would you? I said, you wouldn't have had much fun in Stalingrad, would you?
Not much fun in Stalingrad, no.
Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't introduce you. This is Ron. Ron Ribbentrop.
Oh, not Von Ribbentrop, eh?
Nein! Oh! Different other chap. I, in Somerset, am being born. Von Ribbentrop is born Gotteramerstrasse 46, Dusseldorf, Westgate. So they say.
And this is the quiet one, Heinrich Bimmler.
Oh, pleased to meet you, Squire. I also am not of mine had been born, but I in your Peterborough Lincolnshire was given birth to. But I'm staying in Peterborough Lincolnshire house all time during war, due to jolly old running sores, and was unable to go in the streets or to go visit football matches or go to Nuremberg. I am retired window cleaner and pacifist, without doing war crimes. And I'm glad England won World Cup, Bobby Charlton, Martin Peters, and eating I am lots of chips and fish and hole in the toads and Dundee cakes on Piccadilly Line, don't you know, chap, but... And I was head of Gestapo for 10 years. 5 years. No, nine. Oh, I was not head of Gestapo. I was not. I make a joke.
Oh, Mr. Bimmler, you do have us on. Oh, excuse me, I better get that.
How long are you down here for, Mr. Hilter? Just the fortnight.
What you ask that for? You're a spy. Get on against the wall, British pig. You're going to die.
Take it easy, dicky old chum. He's a bit on edge, Mr. Johnson. He hasn't slept since 1945.
Shut your cake hole, you Nazi.
Call it if you're a cat. The fun we have.
Haven't I seen him on the television?
Nicht! No!
Simon D. Show? Or was it
Crossing? No!
Telephone, Mr. Hilter. It's Mr. McGoring from the Bell and Compasses. He says he's found a place where you can hire bombers by the hour.
If he opens his big mouth again, it's lampshade time!
Shut up! Hire bomber. He's a joker, that Scottish person. Good old Norman.
He's on the phone the whole time now.
In business, is he?
Soon, baby.
Of course, it's his big day, Thursday. They've been planning it for months.
What happens Thursday, then?
Well, it's the North Minehead bomber.